Howdy! If you've read through your NerdKits guide, you've already programmed your brand new microcontroller.
Your first project was a temperature sensor. You wired up the LCD, used the programming cable, and wrote code that reads an analog signal from the temperature sensor and converts it to a digital value and continuously updates the LCD. The code you wrote uses the LCD to show the raw value coming from the analog to digital converter, as well as the average temperature in degrees Fahrenheit.
When you wrote the code, there might have been a few things you didn't understand, like this expression, which tells the analog to digital converter to start a conversion. You might have been confused because when you are writing the code for embedded systems, you need to have a low-level understanding of what's going on in the chip. So we need to understand more about the language of computers, which brings us to why we need to learn about bits, bytes, and binary. In the binary system, we only have two symbols, 0 and 1. We have to be able to represent all the numbers using only these two symbols. Now, in the system you're used to, the decimal system, you have 10 symbols. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. I wonder why they chose 10. Seems sort of arbitrary. Luckily, these two systems work in pretty much the same way. In the decimal system, the ones you're used to, each place is worth a different power of 10, which means each place is worth 10 times as much as the previous one. So, if I was to put a 7 in the 10th place and a 5 in the 1's place, the number I have is just 75. If I was to add a 3 in the 100th place, I would have 300 plus 70 plus 5 equals 375. Now, in the binary system, each place is worth a different power of 2. This is because we only have two numbers to deal with. So, each place is worth twice as much as the previous one. Simply, if I put a 1 in the second place, I just have 2. Now, if I was to add a 1 in the third place, and zeros everywhere else, I would have 4 plus 2, which equals 6. Let's do another example, just to get used to binary numbers. Let's figure out what the number 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0 is in binary. Now remember, in the binary system, each place is a different power of 2. So we have 2 to the 0, 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, and so on, which equals 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and 32. Now, this means that we have 0 32s plus 1 16 plus 1 8 plus 0 4s plus 1 2 plus 0 1s, which equals 16 plus 8 plus 2 is 26. Now, binary numbers are helpful because inside your microcontroller, there are rows and rows of memory locations. Now, in your NerdKits guide, we talked about how we can use circuits to store high or low voltages. Each one of these high or low voltages that we can store, we call a bit. We put 8 of these together to form a byte. Now, notice how if we want to represent really large numbers, we're going to need lots and lots of bits. To store this number, for example, we only need 6 bits. Now, if you go back to your NerdKits guide, we can understand more about what this statement does. You are setting ADCSR equal to a binary number. ADCSR is just the memory location of the chip. This binary number is created using a shift operator, and you're also using the OR operator. You can learn more about both of these operators in a later NerdKits video. Hopefully, you learned something about how we represent numbers in computer science. The same concepts we learned here can be used to represent numbers in different bases, like hexadecimal, which uses 16 symbols to represent numbers. You can find more information about our electronics kits and more videos like these at www.nerdkits.com.